The man who does not read has no advantage over the man who cannot read. Learning programming using an online tutorial is like taking a picture. You click, and that's the end of it. Learning to program with books is like creating a beautiful painting. You layer and layer on it, and keep doing it for weeks. You might still have the same image in the end, but there's going to be a depth to it. I know that we live in a world where everyone wants fast results, and watching online tutorials might seem like the easiest way to learn programming. But the quality of outcomes that you get with books cannot be matched by online tutorials. You can go much deeper with books than you can by using any other way. Additionally, on an actual job, you would not have any video tutorials to help you. You will have to read the documentation and implement things by yourself. So building a habit to read and understand technical stuff is a must to have a good career as a programmer. That's why I'm giving you 5 practical books to get started with. For some of the books, I'll also provide links to YouTube videos that you can watch in case you get stuck. Let's do this. If you want to learn Python by building cool projects, check out this book called Python Crash Course. First half of the book deals with basics like variables, conditionals, loops, and functions, etc. But the real magic happens in the second part of the book where you build projects. You'll be using Pygame package to build an alien invasion game. How does that sound for your first project? You'll be able to shoot down the alien fleet and also have a scoreboard to list the high scores. In the second project, you'll learn how to work with APIs. You'll download some data from GitHub API and visualize it using matplotlib library. In the last project, you'll build a web app using Django, which is a very popular Python web framework. You'll also learn how to style your app using Bootstrap, which is a very popular CSS framework. At the end, you'll deploy your website to the cloud to make it available for the entire world to see. The video guide of this book is linked in the description. After completing this book, you'll feel confident enough to build your own Python projects. Next, I have a great recommendation for all the web development folks out there. If you want to have deep understanding of JavaScript, try this book called Eloquent JavaScript. This book is available online legally for free. And the best part is that you can try out all the exercises in this book on the same website. In the first part of the book, you'll learn the basics of JavaScript. In the second part, you'll learn about how JavaScript interacts with the browser and document object model or DOM. And finally, in the last part, you'll learn about how to run JavaScript on the server instead of the browser. Every chapter gives you exercises to test your knowledge. Additionally, you'll also build some very cool projects. You'll build a brand new programming language called Egg. You'll also make a web app to edit pixel art. In the final project, you'll build a website that lets people organize meetings to share their skills with each other. Unfortunately, there is no video guide on YouTube that covers the entire book. I will link a playlist that covers the first 6 chapters of the book. If enough people go and support the creator of the playlist, I'm hoping that he will complete the book. Next, we have a timeless classic. The Pragmatic Programmer. The principles presented in this book are not tied to any particular technology or programming language. This makes them applicable even today, though the book was published long time back in 1999. The Pragmatic Programmer covers topics like debugging, testing, automation, and communication, providing a well-rounded perspective on what it takes to become an effective software developer. It focuses on fundamental principles and best practices that can be applied in any programming context. The best part about this book is the clever metaphors and analogies it uses to explain complex technical concepts. For example, it proposes the idea of code kata. The word kata means form in Japanese and is often used to describe repetition of certain motions in karate to reinforce learnings. By doing code kata exercises, programmers can also reinforce their knowledge of algorithms, data structures, and design patterns. Whether you are a beginner or an experienced programmer, this book has something for everyone. And this makes it a must-read for anyone who is serious about honing their craft as a programmer. So you've learned a couple of programming languages and have now become a pragmatic programmer. Next, you need to know how to write clean code. For that, we have another classic, Clean Code by Uncle Bob. The primary goal of Clean Code is to improve readability and maintainability of your code. It teaches you how to write code that is easy for other developers to understand, modify, and extend. Clean Code also tells you when and when not to use comments. It encourages developers to write self-explanatory code instead of relying heavily on comments. It also covers how to name your variables, functions, and classes. The book uses real-world examples to drive the point home. Uncle Bob provides code snippets in Java, but you can easily apply the ideas to other languages. The book also covers design principles like single responsibility principles and DRY. The book does become a little opinionated at times, so you don't have to follow everything to a T, but it's still a great starting point to improve the quality of your code. If you want to go from junior developer to senior developer, you have to start thinking beyond code. You need to know how to architect your services in a way that they can handle thousands of simultaneous requests at the same time. For that, You should read Designing Data-Intensive Applications, or DDIA for short. This book introduces you to different challenges involved in building systems that are reliable, scalable, and maintainable. You will learn when to use relational databases versus NoSQL databases. DDIA will also help you understand how databases efficiently store and fetch data. It will also teach you how to distribute your data to multiple machines if your data becomes too large to fit in one machine. While the book covers a lot of theory, it also provides practical guidance on how to apply these concepts to a real-world scenario. It does so by providing case studies on how big companies like Google and Amazon handle their data. DDIA also covers emerging trends in data systems like new databases and storage technologies. If you want to learn how to make common trade-offs when building large applications, DDIA is a great read. If you want to build a deeper understanding of concepts, books is a great way to do it. But if you're looking for fast results and prefer online courses, I have tried 50 programming courses. Watch this video to know the top 5 that I recommend. My name is Sahil, and I'll see you in the next one.